will make you fishers of men, fishers of men, fishers of men. I will make you fishers of men if you follow me. I will make you fishers of men if you follow me.
Amen. we should not appreciate that God is angry. God is not happy with that generation. As David said in Psalm 7:11, that God is angry with the wicked every day, and he justified and helped the righteous. Are you one of the wicked who say, I will never repent, I will never amend my way? And you're here in your compound, or everybody there is your enemy. And the market area, everybody is your enemy. Where you go to buy and sell, everybody's enemy. In the village, don't even go to village, because all of them are witches in the village. All of them are wizards in the village. You don't travel, any neighbor come, run away. They're witches. Oh yes, that means you don't know the voice of Christ. Now we're told here why they are feasting in sin. Oh no, ruling and rumbling in iniquity. And iniquity was ruling that community, that nation, that generation of Noah. And the Bible says, and God was grieving his heart. Verse 7. And the Lord pronounced judgment. What did he say? I am the one that created them. President is the one that made you. Governor is the one that made you. Preacher is the one that made you. General overseer is the one that made you. Oh yeah, apostle, pastor, reverend, bishop, doctor, mommy of the church, daddy of the church. He's the one that made you. He has right to kill you if he want to. He has right to spare you if he want to. In this time, nobody can question him. What did he say? He has concluded matter. Why was he destroying them? Why would he destroy them? Because their iniquity, their wickedness is too much that have come to God in a for remembrance. And the Lord said, I will destroy man whom I have created. Not the devil created you. Devil did not create you. Obanje did not create you. Ayelala did not create you. Witchcraft did not create you. No father, no mother created you. No human being. Only God created. He said, I will destroy man. Man, have you heard it? God say, I will destroy man whom I have what? Created from the face of the earth. Both man and the beast. The sin of man affected the earth. The sin of man affected the land. The sin of man affected the beast. The sin of the man affected the birds. The sin of man affected all the cattle. The sin of man, oh yes, corruption, corruption. And they are breathing it, and they are breathing it in. And that is why the Lord said, I will spare them, I will also destroy both of them. But Bible said in verse 8. Amen. Oh, let me finish verse 7. I have created from the face of the earth, both man and the beast, and the creeping thing, and the fowls of the air, for it repented me, that I have made them. This age, in this judgment, in this sentence, in God's furious anger, there was a voice of grace. What was the voice? And Noah found grace in the sight of God. Amen. Somebody today will find grace in the sight of God. And this month shall be the month of grace. I say this month shall be the month of grace. I say this month has been declared the month of grace. The Lord will show us the way out. He will show you the way out. He will show you favor in the morning, favor in the afternoon, favor in the evening, favor in the night. As you go, as you come in, wherever you go, grace shall locate you. I say grace shall locate somebody. Oh yes, your sin is too much. Grace is available. Your wickedness is too much. Grace is available. Your backsliding is too much. Grace is available. Your anger, your bitterness, grace is available. And Noah, hallelujah, found grace in the sight of who? Amen. Who is the brother? Who is the man? Who is the woman? Who is the boy? Who is that girl that will find grace today? I want to find grace in the sight today. Do you want to find grace? The Lord is grace himself. I say his name is grace himself. Amen. As you desire it, it shall be yours in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, brethren, that grace that Noah found affected so many things around him. The wife was not mentioned at the beginning, but the wife benefited from that grace. The three sons also found the same world. The grace of their father affected them. Also, the same grace came to the, you know, beast, birds. The same grace of Noah affected these ones. And the Lord also, even those that are not clean, those beings that are not clean, the grace of Noah did what was extended to them. If there is anybody here living unclean life, the grace of God will change your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Is anybody here living a city life? The grace of God will locate you in the name of Jesus. Is there anyone here a backslider? I say God's grace is on your way to deliver you, to deliver you, to deliver you. And they said it in the name of Jesus. Even unclean beasts were saved by the grace in the life of Noah. Unclean beasts were saved. And the Lord said to Noah, because of you, spare seven clean beasts, male and female, that's 14. And all the creeping things that are on the earth, which is unclean, spare them 42, that's 4 apiece, male and female. And all the best, spare them. Oh, yeah, those that are clean, 7, 14. And those that are not clean, 2 by 2, male and female, 4. And all of them shall enter with you in the ark of grace. Amen. Amen. Now, what am I trying to imply? The voice of grace, the voice of message, the voice of the Lord. Now, how could Noah bring in elephant into the ark? How could Noah bring in lion, bear, leopard? How could, are you following now? How could Noah drag in bush dog and all those violent animals? The same grace. It's ever said the same grace. Ever said the same grace. Immediately God spoke to Noah. And Noah raised his voice and began to go. In that land, there were more than millions and thousands of clean beasts. But the first seven male and the first seven female that had the voice, everybody had the voice. The voice of grace. Everybody said the voice of grace. Hallelujah. They say, now our God who created us, may we enter. Immediately seven male enter. Seven female what? Amen. No other one had the voice and could enter. They sent it all the best, all the lions, everyone, according to the voice. And Noah blew the trumpet and said, it is time. It is now. 120 years I have been building this ark, announcing to you that the day has come. Immediately Noah was 600 years thus was God's. That means Noah started building the ark when he was 480 years. And immediately he finished the building of the ark, he was 600 years old. And Bible say, the Lord said, Noah, that preparation you have been preparing, it is now. Blow the voice of grace. That because you have found grace in my sight, I prophesy the features of me. God is showing us grace. This church enjoy God's favor. We enjoy God's mercy. We enjoy God's grace. We are not educated than them. We are not more righteous than them. We are not more holy than them. We are not wise than them. We are not richer than them. But we find grace. This message you are hearing, I didn't get it from my brain. I didn't get it from the Bible school or seminary. I get it from grace. And I'm yet sharing it with you by grace. And that grace will set you free. I say grace will set you free. I say grace will set you free. I say grace will keep you for God. I say grace will mature you for God. I say grace will make you to be holy. I say grace will make you to be raptured. I say grace will keep us unto the last day. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. place of grace, arrested all the animals according to the same voice. They enter the ark. All the birds, according to their family, enter the ark. All the creeping things, according to their family, enter the ark. And the Lord was watching. And the Lord was watching. Brother, you are the next person. The door will not be shut until you enter. I said the door will not be shut until I enter. I said the door will not be shut until we enter. I said when we enter. I said when we enter. I said when we enter. We'll never be drawn in the fire. In the fire. We'll never be drawn in the water. We shall enter in the name of Jesus. No matter the trials of life. No matter the challenges of life. No matter the tribulation. No matter the suffering. No matter the hunger. No matter the persecution. No matter the trial. No matter the insolence. No matter the mockery. Grace will see us through. Amazing grace that saves a wretched sinner like me. Amazing grace. That grace that saved me, the grace will keep me. That grace that saved you, the grace will keep you. Until the day, in the name of Jesus. Oh, the voice of grace. Oh, the voice of grace. All the animals enter. All the birds enter. Every creeping thing enter. And the Bible says, the Lord said to Noah, Noah, it is time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Until the last one entered, the Lord shut the door and shut them in for safety and shut others out for destruction. Brother, are you in or out? Sinner, are you in or out? Backslider, are you in or out? You are in this world. This world has been marked for destruction. This world has been reserved for fire. Whether Europe, whether Africa, whether America, whatever, they have been reserved for judgment. And God's anger of judgment is raging. But in the midst of this judgment, in the midst of this anger, they see a voice of grace. And that's what you're hearing now. It is time to escape or never. It is either now or never. It doesn't matter what is the opinion of the crowd. It doesn't matter what is the opinion of the multitude. People say, are you sure? Is it only the church that talk about we go to heaven? What of other churches? What that reverend? What that bishop? What? Oh yes, you can answer that by yourself. You will ask, no, what of other big, big men? What of that those who do not believe his message? What of what? You ask, no, where were they? Where were they? Even though they say, in politics, in what we call democracy, it is a game of number. Game of what? They say majority carry the. But in heavenly game, it's minority. Very few that enter through the road. The other multitude on their way to destruction. So he said, I want to follow big church. I want to follow worldwide church. I want to be big time pastor, big time preacher. You can follow them, but they will take you to hell where they're going to. But if you want to follow Jesus, you want to follow the voice of grace, the voice of love, the voice of favor, which is the voice of Jesus, then it is now you can make up your mind. Stop playing church. Stop playing religion. Stop playing pretentious living. Rather, confess your sin today. Repent genuinely and say, Lord, I don't want to see hell. Neither will I breathe it. I want to see you on the last day. And the Bible says, whatever thing you desire, when you believe, pray, it will come to pass. And the Bible says, whosoever will call upon the name of the Lord, the same shall be. Are you ready to call today? If you call, you shall be saved. I say if you call, you shall be saved. I say if you call, you shall be saved. I say if you call, you shall be saved. I say you shall be saved. I say the Lord will save you in the name of Jesus. Now Noah obeyed the voice of grace, he was saved. His family obeyed the voice of grace, they were saved. All the animals that had the voice of grace and obeyed the voice, they were saved. But others who had in their hearts, others
Others who ask, who are stubborn. Others who say, how can God is stubborn? God is not wicked. God is not. Look, grace, grace, grace. You know, the same grace, the same grace, the same grace. And they continue in that until they were wiped away by God's raging anger. Bible says, the fountain of the earth opened. Water was coming from where? Under the earth. And heavens were what? Where what? Water was coming from up. Coming from where? No escape. You that say you are going to enter hellfire with chemical, with your fornication chemical, with your adultery chemical, with your stealing chemical, that you know scientists now, nothing they cannot do. There's a chemical when you use it to enter hellfire. You remember that even when in the days of Elijah, the Lord turned water to what? Turn water to what? To fire. Amen. So when you carry your chemical, we are going to see you. You will regret ever coming into this world. Because you despise the voice of grace. You will regret ever being born into this world. Because you despise the voice of salvation, the voice of mercy, the voice of truth, the voice of reconciliation, the voice of salvation. You despise it. Because the Lord is calling you, showing you passionately, lovingly, caring for you to escape. You say no. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8 and 9. For by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God. Not of works, lest any man should. Amen. Amen. For by grace are ye saved. Not of yourselves, it is the gift of God. Lest any man should boast. It is not of works, it's not of labor. Let me know that they saved that judgment. The Bible says he was the one that God found to be righteous in that generation. It didn't say he was perfect. Maybe say, I am not perfect. Yes, Jesus came to make you perfect. Many say, how will I be perfect? Jesus came to make you perfect. But Noah was not perfect, but he was righteous. What do you mean by righteous? An upright man, he obey God, he fear God. Whatever God asks him to do, that's what he does. That's what makes him righteous. Now, by grace, we are justified. By grace, we are made righteous. By grace, we are made children of God. Not of ourselves, not of our labor, not of our words. We cannot buy with money. We cannot buy with tithe and offering. It is a gift of God that God has given us. So, salvation is a gift from God. Forgiveness is a gift from God. Making eternal life is a gift from God. Because that same Noah, if you read further, you discover that even when he had been secured and rescued by God, and he came back and planted a farm, and the thing yielded, and whatever, he decided to marry him. And he got drunk, amen, amen, and became what? Became naked. So it is grace. Everyone say grace. Not your own righteousness. Not my own righteousness. And that grace has been made available in only one man. Everyone say only one man. Who is that man? Who is that man?
Beloved, if you have been blessed by this message and you wish to give your life to Jesus Christ, say this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, acknowledge that I'm a sinner. I come to you for mercy. Cleanse me with your blood and make me a new creature. As I accept you as my Lord and personal Savior, I will live for you all the days of my life. Amen. Congratulations, you are now a child of God. You can worship in any of our branch or any Bible-believing practicing church close to you. Your life will never remain the same. God bless you.